What is something you will only buy name brand? Toilet paper. The good stuff is a necessity. I bought cheap toilet paper once. Bet you got real in touch with yourself. Cheap is not the same as inexpensive though. I actually like the Costco brand paper. Doritos. I've never had a generic version that tasted anything close to the original. Trash bags. I live on the third floor. Started using the Costco ones last year, they the truth. Computer parts, especially hard drives. Quick question, what does qualify as off-brand computer parts, like unbranded RAM? Probably means going with more known brands like WD and Seagate for HDDs for example. Bigger and more known brands have usually better reliability, customer support and warranty. Definitely don't buy random no-name parts off eBay, unless it's a very budget PC build. Look for white drives on eBay. Ketchup and boxed mac and cheese. You better not be combining those two. Barbecue sauce. I live and die by Sweet Baby Ray's. Never liked barbecue sauce, until they came around. That stuff is too sweet for me. The Rufus Cheek though, is killer. He really did make some sauce. People rave about Sweet Baby Ray's, but it's just sugar. I did grow up in Texas though, where you have like 40 different bottles to choose from at the grocery store, so maybe they live in a place with not many choices. Meat fibers. Real Kraft mac and cheese. The powdered cheese in the cheaper ones just doesn't dissolve. Kraft Dinner is the bomb. As a university student, I have basically subsisted off it. Jif peanut butter. Nothing else compares. Gotta disagree here, my man. I switched from Jif to Justin's, and now I find that Jif has too much sugar in it. Adam's natural PB is unbeatable. Jif for eating. Skippy for baking sweets. Shampoo conditioner. Off-brand or brands that aren't salon quality are bad for my hair. Waterproof things such as rain jackets and camera backpacks. I'll only buy name brand boats. Patagonia has good rain jackets, and they'll replace it for you. I own a Patagonia rain jacket, duffel bag, jersey, and cap lol. Their stuff is incredible. I know right. I have one of their backpacks that I got in 5th grade and am going to college with the same one. It's also been all around the country and the world. The things are bomb-proof. Worth every penny. Coca-Cola. Like who likes the great value cola? 99¢ 2 liters at Walgreens will get you like that. Toilet paper. Otherwise you're wiping with 80 grits and paper, or it's thinner than ghost diarrhea. Pop-Tarts. Store brand is terrible. Beans. The bootleg ones made me so constipated I literally thought I was dying. Goldfish. Don't mess with off-brand snacks. Shoes mainly. All the unbranded shoes I've ever owned broke in like a month or two, whereas all my Adidas shoes lasted me well over 2 years. Totally agree. I don't even like buying shoes from fast fashion brands. That is a recipe for disaster. I try to save and buy high quality shoes, sneakers that will last for a good time and hold their value when treated with love and care. I pretty much only buy Red Wing shoes. A little prissy, but worth every cent. Plus, not everyone makes steel toe shoes, just boots. Red Wings are the best. Bought some $30 Brahmas once, that's the warmer boots. Lasted a day for every dollar spent. Meanwhile my actual Red Wings are 5 years old, only recently not waterproof anymore, and need new soles soon. I got some Albertz on recommendation from the wife Aka. She bought me some Albertz. Probably my favorite pair of shoes I've owned in the last 4 years. Good shoes are the most important thing. Almost any high-end electronic device. I almost never buy any high-end electronic device if I do not recognize the brand. However, if I don't know the brand, but they are highly regarded, I do my research and decide from there. Yeah, the name brands are often more expensive, but more times than not, they are worth the extra money, especially computer parts. My deodorant. Secret gel, not solid. I can't stand anything else. My uncle once told me to never skimp on toilet paper or hot dog buns. I always go top quality on both, and I gotta say I'm living my best life. Q-tips. I need them desperately for my job. Off-brand ones break too easily. The cotton comes off on the no-brand ones. Shoes. I buy everything used or off-brand except shoes. Vinegars, salt, knives. Guess my profession. I just realized this pencils. Ticonderoga FTW. Also for mechanical, papermate. Fight me. Work boots. Whenever I buy a cheap pair they last a few months at best, but the expensive ones last for years. Sneakers. I've only worn New Balance since the mid to late 90s. Even other name brands will often give me blisters, something about the shape of my arch, but I've never had that problem with NB. Volleyball's Castaway made me a Wilson Stan. Video game controllers and hardware, too much experience with that from my PS3 days. Wax strips. I tried the store brand and a cheaper brand, but they don't get the job done, or maybe they would, if I didn't have so much hair. Toilet paper, 3-ply cottonal and ketchup jeans. Handbags, Macupe, clothing, self-care products. Watches. Cause men deserve to have fine jewelry too. Shoes. I used to just get the cheapest thing I can find, but I've really learned the value of quality brands when it comes to footwear. Better to buy a $100 pair that lasts years than a $30 pair that will be worn and discolored after 6 months. Plus the fit and styles are usually way better. They say to buy the most expensive shoes and mattress you can afford. You spend most of your day in one or the other, might as well be comfortable. Pay for quality and things that come between you and the ground: mattress, shoes, tires. Tide laundry soap, toilet paper, and Meritian ramen, none of that top ramen stuffs. Dr. Pepper, I drink it more than water and I rarely get the off-brand drinks. Condoms, cause I'd rather pay for decent condoms than a kid. Tires. Ever heard of Linglongs? Cinnamon Toast Crunch, Bagel Bites, and Pizza Rolls. Pop-Tarts and Diet Coke. Store brands are trash. Oatmeal. I can't stand the homemade stuff. My birth control. It's for endometriosis, and any brand or off-brand besides the one I'm taking results in a very, very bad time. Ketchup, beans, mustard, French's, mayonnaise, Hellman's, Best Foods, Worcestershire sauce, Lee and Perrin soy sauce, Kirkoman, Caesar dressing, Cardinus browning, seasoning, kitchen book, A stock better than bouillon, instant gravy sauces, nor steak sauce, A1 and Eden's 57, baked beans, B&M. Nachos, they have to be Tostitos. Not Doritos, I know both are from PepsiCo, just Tostitos. They taste good. They look good. You'd step over your own mother just to get one. I like the Mexican ones you can find sometimes. The real corn ones. Not always cheaper than Tostitos, but sometimes, and they're so good. You know, I've recently decided that I'm done with tortilla chips. I'm pretty disappointed by it though. I pretty much only buy Nike when I go shoe shopping. Underwear. Victoria's Secret all the way. And Heinz ketchup. I only drink Coca-Cola. Nothing else soda-wise. Chapstick or Burt's Bees brand lip balm only. For me it's Carmex. Been using it for 2 decades. My lips don't like Carmex or EOS. They end up chapping worse. I have the same issue with Burt's Bees. Cough syrup. Generic tastes so much worse. Will get generic for any other type of med, but I bought generic NyQuil once, and it took forever to get the taste out of my mouth. Maple syrup. Generic tastes like melted plastic. Potato chips. Off-brand chips are disgusting. Q-tips. I haven't been living by this lately, but it's the absolute best, aside from one cotton swab that I had in a hotel in Panama, that the stick was made from bamboo. I haven't been able to find those for purchase though. Dan and Phil merch. No thank you, Redbubble. Jeans. They're only a handful of brands that actually fit me right without giving me a huge gap in the waist. Any recommendations? All the jeans I currently own just slide down as I walk, even if they're not technically big on me. I like silver jeans, but they can be expensive. What's nice about this brand is that they size like men's do waist length instead of something vague like 9. They also carry fit styles. Suki fit me the best by far. It's the curvy style that fit wide hips, but normal waist well. There are other fit styles, if that's not your body type. Most of the time I can pick a Suki in a 30 or 31, and it will fit. There is some play depending on the fabric of that particular pair. I used to buy Aria jeans, but I can't seem to find them anymore. I think they might have been discontinued. Pizza. Supermarket pizzas just taste like a cardboard. I try to buy store brands as much as I can. However, I refuse to buy store brand barbecue sauce. It's Sweet Baby Ray's, or the highway as far as I'm concerned. Shoes. The last time I got a pair of cheap Payless shoes, they were destroyed in a week. I wasn't even hard on them either. Lupe Case Brooks running shoes. My progressive eyeglass lenses. It's been a while since I bought new glasses. Crystal is the brand, I think. Dish liquid. Specifically, Dawn. Clothing with clip art, because 90% of it is stolen, and as an artist, I'm highly against it, no matter how much of a bargain it is. Disney movies, looking at you, Will Smith as a genie. Cheese strings, that tiger copy is disgusting. Shoes. I cannot describe how uncomfortable just trying on Walmart brand shoes are. Painkillers. My period cramps are bad, and I just tore a ligament, so been having to have a lot. Definitely recommend Advil and Nurofen over that other cheaper stuff. Lots of people say it works the same, but both my parents' doctor and my doctor say it's different. Doc Martens. They're such good quality shoes. I own one basic black pair. Bought it 6 years ago. I brought it to parties, amusement parks, long walks, pretty much everywhere, and they are still fine, and judging from what other people have said, will stay that way for a long time. I'm thinking of getting an extra pair in burgundy after my summer job. I have a pair that is like 7 years old, still going strong. I spend more on shoes nowadays. I walk a lot in general. I used to buy Nike sneakers, but I would wear through the soles in 6 months. Like full on, I can put my finger through the holes in the sole. Now I pretty much wear Dr. Martens or Merrell walking shoes, unless I have to wear something formal. Not brand name per se, but more of a tier level, and that's flagship smartphones like the iPhone or Samsung Galaxy Note or S series. I'm a power user and now getting my own business started. I typically hang on to them for at least a couple years before upgrading, but I like having a fast phone with good performance.